Hello, you're watching The 86th Floor. Now, one of our favourite programmes ever, Outlander, is returning this week. So basically, Outlander is a kind of science fiction slash period drama about a woman who travels back in time. So I'm going to recap what happened towards the end of the first half of the season. If you missed anything like major before that, then I did do another recap, which you can check out right here. Otherwise, let's crack on. So in the last few episodes, Claire has realised that the Mackenzie men are actually going around collecting money for the Jacobite army, which she knows will be defeated and most of them will be killed in 3 years' time. She knows that from history, obviously, because she is from the year 1945.
I'm trying to warn you.
Warn me about what?
Dougal and his men trust her now. They no longer think she's a spy, but now the English redcoats do think she's a spy, and they keep trying to capture her, to interrogate her. So in order to avoid Captain Randall, Dougal has arranged for Claire to marry one of his men so that she technically becomes a Scot and doesn't have to go to see Captain Blackjack Randall, who's so evil. So surprise, surprise, guess who he chooses for Claire to marry? Jamie Fraser, of course. So they are actually married now. Yep, they're married now, and they had a really, really sweet wedding. Although Claire drank loads because she felt really weird about it and was quite hungover during the wedding, which probably wasn't great. But they're totally falling in love. They're actually quite cringy, but it's sweet. But Claire still feels very much that she's married to Frank Randall, who's in the present of 1945. So she's got quite conflicting emotions and she doesn't really know how to deal with it. Frank, meanwhile, in the present day of 1945, has been looking for Claire for 6 weeks, and he refuses to believe that she's just left him and run off with another lover. So he doesn't know what's happened to her, although he's still suspicious about the man or the ghost or whoever it was that he saw in the first episode looking up at Claire's window. The Reverend, who he's staying with, tells him that he thinks he should just leave Inverness and go back to Oxford. But the Reverend's housekeeper tells him that she has a theory that Claire has actually fallen through time at the rocks at Craig na Doon. But unfortunately, Frank just thinks that she's talking nonsense and packs his bags and leaves to go back home. In the most recent episode, we saw him leaving Inverness in his car. But then when he gets to the turnoff for Craig na Doon, he stops his car. Meanwhile, Claire, Jamie and the other clansmen are on their way to see a man called Horrocks, who's an English redcoat deserter, who says he might be able to prove Jamie's innocence because he knows who committed the murder that Jamie's been accused of. So basically, Jamie was accused of a murder that he didn't do and has been living in hiding because of it. So he may have a chance to prove his innocence. They unfortunately meet quite a lot of trouble on their journey, and Claire nearly gets raped again. She gets raped, or almost raped, quite a lot in Outlander. But yeah, this happens because her and Jamie are like canoodling in a meadow, and then two other redcoat deserters find them and hold them at gunpoint. And Claire manages to actually kill the one who's on top of her by stabbing him in the kidneys. Go, Claire. Girl power. Independent woman. So yeah, she kills one of the men and goes into shock about it. And then just starts to feel really pissed off with the whole situation and is quite angry. Jamie feels really bad and leaves her in the protection of Willie, who's one of the clansmen, even though she doesn't need anyone to look after her, because as I said, she's an independent woman. Willie then says that he needs to go to the toilet and leaves Claire on her own, sort of on the mountainside. So when Willie goes off to use the toilet, Claire spots the stone circle of Craig na Doon in the distance and realises that, ta-da, she's actually at the spot that she's been looking for the whole time. She decides that although she is in love with Jamie now, she's still definitely in love with Frank, and she wants to get back to her own time. So she starts to make her way towards the rocks at Craig na Doon. Meanwhile, in the present day, we see Frank, who stopped his car at the turnoff, getting out of his car, walking up towards the rocks in a last-ditched attempt to try and find Claire at these rocks that the housekeeper had told him about. He calls her name and she kind of hears his distant voice. So she starts to run towards the rocks, but just before she manages to touch the rock and fall back through time, she gets captured by two redcoats and taken to Fort William. Frank leaves the stone circle, like really sad, obviously thinking she's definitely left me. So poor old Claire's taken to Fort William again, where she is interrogated again by Captain Randall. And she tries to make up a story about the Duke of Sandringham, basically making out that she is a spy, just like he is, kind of. But he realises that she's telling a lie when she doesn't know whether the Duke of Sandringham is married or not. So then he gets really angry and holds her at knife point and tries to rape her again. But just in time, she looks up and sees Jamie, and he bursts through the door being like, "Get off my wife!" And that's how the season ends.
Starz's new supernatural costume drama Outlander is proving to be a massive success. It's broken the multi-platform viewing record for the Starz channel.